On December 28, 1927, Elizabeth married her life partner, Levi Barnes, a soft-spoken, hard-working Southern gentleman with a serious green thumb, from nearby Fountain, North Carolina. It was soon after marrying Levi that Elizabeth mastered what would eventually be her greatest skill.
She was 15 when she got married, and Granddaddy was 17, so they were very young. Grandma told me that she thought that, she thought she knew how to cook because she said that her sisters would take her into the kitchen with them when they were cooking, and they would, show her, so she would be watching them. So she said she used to tell people that she knew how to cook. But she said when she got married, she realized that she didn't know how to cook. And so she said that a lot of people, that there would be people, some of maybe Granddaddy's sister, Aileen, and other people would come over to the house sometimes and help her out, and taught her some things about cooking. And she even said that Granddaddy taught her some things about cooking because she said that he knew how to cook some. So she learned, and of course we all know that Grandma became the master cook that we all, know and love. La, 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 la,
la, la, la, la, la. Levi and Elizabeth had their first child, Nora, very soon after their marriage. Although Elizabeth insists she only planned to have one child, a few years later they had their second child, Bernestine, and then came the boys. Love and happiness. Wait a minute. There was Lee, Ray, James, Earl, David, Lawrence, and Bill before they had their next girl, Mary. Talking about how she can make it right, yeah. Finally, there was Orlando, aka Paps, and Evelyn, aka Cheryl. The Barnes children have lots of fond memories of growing up with Elizabeth.
I remember years ago she taught us to say our prayers at night. In the morning, we always had to say a breakfast prayer. And on Sunday, we always said Bible verses.
One of the main things I remember about Mama was her demeanor. She was so cool, Me and Cheryl could go out and, break something or destroy something. And she would be always humming her little song and grab a switch and beat both of us, and keep humming the same song, She never got upset, That was the main thing.
I especially remember in 1973, Mom and I were getting ready to take a trip to Las Vegas, and we got to Chicago and we had to change flights. And everybody had told me the airport in Chicago was pretty big, so to make sure I found my next flight, before I got too comfortable. So I found the flight, and all of a sudden Mom wanted to go buy these postcards. So I tried to explain to her that, we really needed to stay put, and we didn't have that much time. So she insisted on getting the postcards, so she decided to go by herself to get them. Well, I'm sitting there, and they call our flight, and no Mom. Then a few minutes later, they say, last call for flight to Chicago, to Las Vegas, and no Mom. So needless to say, we missed the flight. And then I had to go find her. And when I did, she says, well, why did you let me go get those postcards?
One of Mama's famous saying was, one monkey didn't stop no show. For instance, we'd be going out to go to work in the fields, and somebody be missing. Lawrence. And Daddy wanted to stop the whole show, And Mama's, favorite word would be, one monkey don't stop no show. We don't do this,
I remember the nice dinners she used to cook, mm-hmm. collard greens and make the nice cakes. I haven't had that since I left mom.
And I remember when I was in high school, I had a part-time job. I was driving a school bus, and I backed over this guy's mailbox, you know, not intentionally. And I had to turn around in his yard, and I backed over the mailbox. And, of course, I got fired. The principal fired me, you know. Oh, man. And I went home and told Mama my story. And Mama went to the school, and she talked to the principal, you know. And he gave me my job back, gave me my bus back, you know. And, I really had fond memories about that, you know. And she really went to the bat for me that time, you know. And I made sure that it would never happen again.
Whether it were her numerous grandkids, prospective in-laws, or friends of the family, coming down to Fountain, North Carolina to meet Elizabeth has become a rite of passage. On each trip, the lesson remains constant. Everyone is part of the family once they've met Elizabeth.
When I married Lee, that was my first time in North Carolina. I was welcomed into the family, and I enjoyed the food, and I always went to church with my mother-in-law.
Started to go to church with my husband's mother, and they belonged to the same church, St. James Church. And I can remember her, I can even visualize it now. She had long black hair, and I thought that it was just so beautiful. And she would be out under the trees. They had a wire fence under the trees where they served quarterly meat and dinner. And she would be out there walking around, serving her food and talking to different people.
Fondest memories of going to visit Grandma was when I was about 6 years old. I went with my granddaddy, Ray, and we went down there. I was so excited to go take that train ride. I remember Uncle James picking us up at the station. And just when we got there, I was so enthused about being there. But when nighttime rolled around, I remember screaming and crying my eyes out. And I remember Grandma whispering for me to come sit at the stand in the kitchen. And me and Granddad had supper that night. And I forgot all about crying. My tears dried up and I was just feeding my face.
When I first met Sis Liz was about 38, 39 years ago when I met her daughter. And my first trip down there, I remember that she was such a good cook, and she has all this delicious food down there. And we spent the night, and she just seemed like the lady can just cook dirt and make it taste good. And I gained 63 pounds in 6 months after meeting my mother-in-law.
She had this rocking chair in her kitchen. And if anyone knows about this rocking chair, anytime she was trying to get me to go to sleep, she would sit me down in this rocking chair and we would just rock. And that thing used to creak something serious. And I still think about it. Every time I walk in the door, I immediately look at that spot and look for that rocking chair. I think it's somewhere in the house somewhere, but it's not the same. But I love it. I love it.
When I met her and I saw the house, the farm, all the fruit trees, and I looked into her eyes, and it made me really, really happy and sad and grateful all at the same time because I saw my grandmother in her.
I remember when I used to spend time with Grandma, we used to walk up and down the road together and talk. Then when I was young, she used to teach me how to pick blueberries off the tree.
My most memorable moment is every time I see Grandma Barnes, she asks me, "I haven't seen you in a while." And then I say, "Oh, I just saw you Christmas." "Not at my house, I haven't seen you."